In the email, you've not written anything in the email. You've written the subject, application for so and so and so. You've
attached the document. Why did you write?
And you have attached the document and you sent it. What do you want to do? By 31st of December. It's possible. It's possible anymore. Yeah. Today, we are going to talk about something that I personally have realized that a lot of young people need to know about, especially prospective students to universities, not just University of Ghana, but to anywhere, that job application, to the school, or anything at all. These are some of the things we wish you would know and take care of the next time you are putting an application to either a school or to a job for employment.
Or even scholarships.
Or scholarships, yeah. So,
I'll start off by, once again, one of my pet peeves when it comes to this. So, in the field that I've been working in, I've been dealing with a lot of applications. Now, one of the things I've noticed over the past few years is that people would send in the application and their email address is poshbeauty66@yahoo.com.
Yeah.
The best thing to do if you're applying, if you're sending in your application for a job or school admission or scholarship, whatever application you're putting in, use a formal email address. So the name is Nansumusua. Nansumusua@gmail.com or at yahoo.com. Or you can use your student email address. Now, still on the subject of email addresses, whichever email address you use on the application, make sure that it's an email that you always check. Because we've had cases where I've even known someone personally, and then also the students I've been dealing with, where you send a communication out to them, maybe like, okay, you've been shortlisted, sending these additional documents, or you have this interview. The day before the interview, they're calling, we haven't heard back from you.
Meanwhile,
oh, I haven't checked my email in 2 weeks. So if you are applying for a job, you are applying for school, you are applying for a scholarship, whatever you are applying for, first of all, your email address should be a formal one, and secondly, the email address you're going to use to apply for the position or whatever it is, make sure that it's an email address that is current and you check very often, at least once a day.
And that is also to say that in the application letter itself, wherever an email is required, make sure you use the same email address that you are sending the applications to. Use the same email, put it inside there. Don't use separate email address to confuse anyone. We don't have time for that.
So the application form, don't fill in email address nancyousua@gmail.com. And then the actual email that you are going to use for sending the documents is poshbeauty28@gmail.com. No, there should be consistency.
Right. And then talking about the document in general, make sure if it is school you're applying to and you're requesting for 4 documents, make sure you get them. Make sure you get all of them. If they're asking to send them online, scan them neatly.
Mm-hmm.
Be meticulous in all your documents. Read through every one of them carefully. Okay? You will not tolerate any grammatical errors.
You will. So you don't want a situation where you are applying for something, you didn't take your time, you weren't meticulous with your application documents, and then maybe they are looking for just 20 people. They are looking to short this down to, let's say, 20 people. But 400 people have applied. They will now go deeper into the criteria. Okay, who was supposed to have a stamp and didn't have a stamp? Okay, you are
signed. Who was signing?
Have signed. Some people have some documents, they haven't signed it. You are out. So if you are applying for something, once you have all your documents together, take that poster or that email that has all the information. So you make a checklist. So once you are ready to submit, so if you say application form, okay, check, I have it, put it here.
And read through it.
If it says CV, check, I have my CV. If it
says CV, you have to be current, up to date with your CV.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't see
why.
Of course, yeah. I've been part of a process like that before, so I think I'm in the best place to talk about. Talking about CV, don't let the last thing on your CV be from something you did like 10 years ago. So 10 years from there till now, what have you been doing in your life? Please, your CV should be as current as possible. Please continue.
Yeah, so make sure that you're meticulous and then you have a checklist. So once you're ready to submit your documents, if it's physical copies that you're submitting, have a checklist. Okay, I have this. They say this is what you have to have. Okay, check, check, check. I have everything. You put it together and then you put it in an envelope and submit it.
If as you're
supposed to be, exactly. If you're supposed to be submitting it by email, scan, like Nancy said, scan is nice. Don't let it be dark. Don't let it be tilted. Nicely scan. And then if they say everything should be in one
Word document,
one PDF file, don't send the email that you have application, you have this, you have that. They send one PDF file. So you scan everything together, you send one document. So pay attention to detail.
Pay attention
to the deadline. They say 5 p.m. Don't send it at 7:30 and say, I was having issues with my internet.
No one cares.
No. It doesn't matter if you saw the ad just a day before the deadline and you are scrambling to get it done. If 5 p.m. is 5 p.m. It could be one of those things that they will use to cut you off. Because
some actually do not start at 5 p.m.
and start at all. And you can't fault them. You can't
fault
them
at all.
No
copies at all.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we're talking about reading through your documents and being meticulous with everything you're doing. Now, if your application requires that you pay an application fee, please go ahead and pay. And in paying, as Essie rightly mentioned, look through the requirement. There will be a list of banks that you'll be required to pay to the right bank. When you're asked to pay to say EcoBank, and you go and pay to Cal Bank, it's your halal. Pay your application to the right bank as possible. Okay?
And then now when you are sending the email, okay, there have been so many times I've seen this thing where somebody said you are applying for, you want somebody to give you money to pay your fees, and you send the application in the email, you've not written anything in the email, you've written the subject, application for social and so and so, you've attached the
documents, why did you write?
And you have attached the document and you sent it, what do you want to do? You know, so you have to, if you are sending an email, it's just like you're actually writing a letter. So there's the subject, which is the heading, basically. And then the body.
Submission.
And then you, and the sign is nicely with your name, sincerely or whatever. Yeah. But some of them don't even say, dear sir or madam. They just attach, and it's all in capital letters.
And no people's portfolio. If AC is a professor, address it accordingly. If Nancy is a professor, address me accordingly. If I'm a Mrs., please address me accordingly.
That is if you know the
situation, yes. And talking about subjects, I received a lot of emails from most of my subscribers. And I don't believe most of them are in secondary school.
No, but these are things you should know in this secondary.
I don't blame them so much. That's what we are telling them, please. Don't put any mystical rules. And then in the subject area, that's where you're writing your email to me. And don't do that annoying part. Hello? When is the University of Ghana reopening? I've told you countless times, I don't work with the admissions office. Don't ask me, if I send the university an email, I've left their email addresses in all of my videos. In fact, most of my videos, their email addresses are there. Ask them these questions. And you have to be respectful enough for sending an email. Don't send an email to someone at store, they live close by you, or their next door neighbor. If even with that, you still have to be respectful. Address them accordingly. Your email should be as polite as possible as you get straight to the point. Oh, get straight to the point too, because I'm not allowed to sit down and read the landing page.
I always to their language just to say that I'm applying for this thing.
It's interesting. But please take note of all of this, especially those of interns who are not so familiar with emails and all of that. Most of them, they are so conversant with WhatsApp.
No, but so far as you have access to WhatsApp, which means you have access to internet, you have access to Google, which there's a wealth of information there.
Yeah.
So you can just simply Google how to send an email, how to write an email. These are, you can educate yourself on a lot of things just by the use of your phone. So make very good use of your access to internet.
Yes.
Because you spend so much time on WhatsApp and Instagram.
It's very important. It's so much important. But it's important that you ask Google anything you want.
think we will end here.
I'm tired.
So if you have any applications pending soon, whether you're applying for a job or you're in the process of applying for so many jobs, you're applying for school admissions, you're applying for scholarships, we are wishing you all the best and we hope that you take these points seriously so that you'll be shortlisted, so that you'll be interviewed and God willing, you actually get the position that you are.
One thing I left out, after you submit your application, please pray. You have to pray and put into use all the things we've said here. Read through your application, get all the documents. The recommenders, if you are asked to provide a recommender so that he or she can send your recommendation letter on your behalf, make sure you constantly remind them to write a letter for you before the deadline comes. So yeah, we hope you've learned anything or two from this video. If there's anything at all you want us to touch on, leave it in the comment section below and we'll be glad to talk about it for you. Please visit Winging It with AC on YouTube and subscribe to the channel.
Subscribe if you're interested. If you're not interested, don't subscribe. I won't
what was your channel about it?
Okay, my channel is the Motherhood channel. Right. So I'm sharing all my experiences as a first time mother in Ghana. And then I have vlogs, lifestyle, but it's mainly about motherhood. So honestly, if you don't subscribe, that's fine. I just want to subscribe to actually interested in the content that I
have. Oh, yeah. Most of us are expecting mothers in years to come, so if you're interested. So we'll meet you guys same time.
Bye-bye.